I look out there and see an old friend, Annette Lantos. Annette, how are you? Her husband, Tom Lantos, the survivor, was my assistant, was my foreign policy advisor for years. And Tom used to say all the time, Joel, he talked that Hungarian accent, Joel, we must do another fundraiser for AIPAC. I did more fundraisers for AIPAC in the 70s and early 80s than just about as many as anybody. Thank God you weren't putting on shows like this. We would have never made it.
Took the incubators and left the children to die on the cold floor.
But was it true? 2 weeks after the liberation, it became apparent that the story was a complete hoax.
Lyndon McIntyre exposes the big lie of the Gulf crisis and the massive public relations campaign that whipped up war fever in the United States.
They have people on
the president
on
repeated
dialysis.
The incubator story six times in his verbal war against Saddam.
And they had kids in incubators, and they were thrown out of the incubators so that Kuwait could be systematically dismantled.
After the war, the New York Times ran articles condemning Lantos for conspiring with a public relations firm to knowingly produce false testimony, which pushed the U.S. towards war.
You have performed a service of incalculable value.
I could not help but think of my nephew, who, if born premature, might have died that day as well.
She seemed to be alone before the Congressional Human Rights Caucus identified only as a Kuwaiti escapee. But we've discovered she wasn't alone at all, and she wasn't just a simple Kuwaiti escapee. In fact, just a few seats away was her father, Kuwait's ambassador to the United States and Canada. Nayira quickly slipped out of the caucus hearing, back into the protective folds of her family, the extended royal family of Kuwait, headed by the Emir Jabir al-Sabah.